गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ वीनस पब्लिक स्कूल। वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद चैप्टर 3 ऑफ क्लास 7 व्हिच इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मैटर। वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग अवर डिस्कशन विद द बाइफर्केशन ऑफ मैटर इनटू थ्री कैटेगरीज, दैट इज एलिमेंट्स, कंपाउंड्स एंड मिक्सचर्स। एंड यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एलिमेंट्स। लेट मी जस्ट रिमाइंड यू वन मोर टाइम व्हाट इज एलिमेंट। एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, द स्मॉलेस्ट एंटिटी और द स्मॉलेस्ट यूनिट of any substance is atom, and if a substance having only one kind of atom in it, clear, if any substance is having only one kind of atom in it, it will be known as element, clear. Like here for example, gold, Au, so okay, so gold is having only one kind of atom, that is Au atoms, clear. And one Au atom combines, one Au atom would be considered as one molecule, okay. And when we combine number of molecules, we will get a solid shape like a ring or an ornament, clear. Similarly, iron, Fe is one atom of Fe used to form one molecule, and when we combine number of molecules together, it forms a definite shape, which could be a nail, which could be a ship or a tank, whatever it is. And similarly, hydrogen gas, so H2 here, this hydrogen is also would also be considered as a element, because hydrogen, it is consisting of only one kind of atom, that is hydrogen atom. But the problem is, it would not be able to available in free state or in individual state, so that's why it has number. So one molecule of hydrogen consists of two atoms in it, okay. But as the atom are of one kind only, that's why hydrogen would also be considered as H2. Hydrogen would also be considered as element, as eight. Here eight atoms are there in sulfur, one molecule. In one molecule of sulfur, eight atoms are there, that's why it would be considered as element, because it is again having only one kind of atom in it, clear. But we have discussed one example yesterday, that is H2O. So H2O is one molecule, but it would not be considered as element. Why? Because one molecule of water is having two different type of atoms, two different kind of atoms in it, clear. That is hydrogen atom as well as oxygen atom. So one molecule of hydrogen is having typically three atoms in it, but all three are different from each other, like they are not of same kind. That's why it would not be water, one molecule of water would not be considered as element, clear. So are we clear with the elements? So we have discussed one more term, molecule, clear. Yesterday we have discussed one more term, molecule. So we have discussed atom and molecule. So the basic difference in the definition: atom is the smallest unit of any substance which shows all the properties of the substance, okay. Like Au is one atom, one gold atom, and Au is representing all the properties which a gold ring or a gold ornament or a gold biscuit will show, clear. So smallest unit of a substance which shows all the properties of the substance, clear, is an atom. Whereas a molecule, again, a molecule is the smallest unit into which a pure substance can be divided without losing its basic nature or identity. It is the same thing as atom. Like if hydrogen molecule is there, suppose this is one molecule of hydrogen which is having two atoms, if we will divide or break down these two atoms, what is left here? Hydrogen, one atom of hydrogen, and one atom of hydrogen, the properties of one atom of hydrogen is similar to the hydrogen molecule, because there is no difference in the constituent atom, clear. Whereas H2O, when one molecule of water is divided, then it is divided into hydrogen and oxygen, and which are having different properties, clear. So basically, this would not be considered as molecule, but okay. So what it would be considered, clear? Here the question is, what it would be considered? Because here, if we bifurcate it into two different constituents, two substances, clear, then what will happen? Then the properties of this broken down individuals is different from the combined state. the properties of the combined substance. Clear? So what it would be called, this would be our next topic. So we'll discuss it a bit later. So here we are again discussing the definition of molecule. The definition of molecule says smallest unit into which a pure substance can be appear. When we are saying pure substance, then we are saying that substance having only that kind of molecules, that kind of molecules in it. That means water will consist of n number of H2O molecules. Clear? So H2O molecules, when a molecule you divide it, okay, it is the smallest unit. When you break down the whole substance, a bucket full of water, when you break it down and you keep on break it down till the last step, you will find the last substance, which is one molecule of H2O. Clear? This is the smallest unit into which a pure substance can be divided without losing its property. Clear? Its basic nature or identity. Clear? Like HCl, okay, hydrochloric acid. Suppose you are having a beaker or a test tube full of hydrochloric acid, and when you are going to divide it, separate it into the till the last step, you will be getting is last one molecule of HCl, okay, and that is having that one last molecule of HCl is having the same properties of the entire the entire substance which is filled in the test tube. Clear? Similarly, the other molecules like H2O, CO2, O2, H2, S8, all these things are molecules, but they are having n number of atoms in it. Clear? So this is the basic difference between atom and molecule. Now let us move up to the next bifurcation of any matter. So matters can be divided into elements, compounds and mixtures. So we have discussed elements. Under the elements, we have discussed, because the elements are the substances which are having only one kind of atom. So we have discussed atom also between the discussion of elements, and we have discussed the molecules also. Now, compounds. What are compounds? So basically, this is the question. This is the answer of the last question which we have raised. The question which we have raised just a few minutes back. That is, if this one molecule of H2O, separate these two molecules, okay, or when we combine two different type of atoms, like in element there is only one kind of atom is there, but in molecules we have seen there are different kind of atoms. In the examples we have seen hydrogen, chlorine, okay, hydrogen, water, carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen, sodium and chlorine, okay. So here different kind of atoms, different types of atoms are combined together. So what they will be called as? So they will be called as compounds. What are compounds? Compounds is a pure substance formed by a chemical combination of one or more elements. Clear? First of all, when one or more elements combines together, they form compound. Clear? And when they are mixing and they are combining together, they must be combined chemically. Okay? They cannot be separated from each other by physical method, or the change would be irreversible. Clear? The change would be irreversible. Clear? Or irreversible means we cannot physically regain the original things, like hydrogen, okay, plus chlorine, Cl2, it gives you 2HCl. Clear? 2HCl. So basically, when we combine hydrogen and chlorine together, okay, chemically, but through chemical process, what will happen? We will get a compound, a combined. These are two elements, because hydrogen is having only one kind of atom in it, chlorine is having only one kind of atom in it. They are different. They are different substances, and they will be considered as elements. Because we have discussed what are elements. Elements are the substances which are only having one kind of atom in it. So it is having two atoms of hydrogen only, it is having two atoms of chlorine only. So when they are combined chemically, what will happen? They will get a substance which would be called as compound. Okay, so compound. Now the properties of hydrogen atom is different, the properties of chlorine atom is different, sorry, chlorine, hydrogen is different, the properties of hydrogen is different, properties of chlorine is different, and when they combine together, the combined property of the new substance, which is compound, is entirely different from the constituents, from its constituent elements, clear? So this is the most important thing which we need to like memorize, that the chemical properties of elements out of which a compound is formed is entirely different from the compound which is like made, clear? So, and there is one more thing we need to understand, that we have to combine, when we combine these elements together and form a compound, the compound must have a definite proportion by mass, clear? That means HCl, that means the mass, the molecular mass of these elements must be combined in a definite proportion, okay? In a definite proportion, then only they will be form a compound and we will get a new property. So basically, in a very layman's language, in a very easy way, we can understand that everything all around us is the result of a chemical reaction, basically, clear? Like carbon dioxide which we inhale, the oxygen which we exhale, okay, and then sorry, the carbon dioxide which we exhale and the carbon dioxide, the oxygen which we inhale is basically the results of chemical combinations, is a chemical reactions, okay? The food we eat is a breakdown into fats, carbohydrates, minerals, vitamins through a chemical process which is happening inside the stomach, okay? So hydrochloric acid is released by the stomach, and this hydrochloric acid helps helps our digestive system to break down the complex food which we have break down into smaller entities, that is fats, carbohydrates, minerals, vitamins, which is directly absorbed by the body for its energy requirement and growth requirements, clear? So everything around us is happening due to a chemical reaction, and when a chemical reaction is happening, either two substances they get to combine each other and form a new substance, or a complex substance is divided into simpler substances, clear? And the simpler substance will be directly used or absorbed by the organisms, living organisms, non-living organisms, whatever it is. So basically everything around us is a result of chemical reaction, and as a result of chemical reaction, in chemical reaction what is happening, either we know the properties of two different substances, and when we combine them together, what will happen, we got a new substance which is having different properties, and we can use those properties, we can use that substance for our purpose, to solve our purpose, okay? Or there must be a substance which is having some properties and is a combination of, and seems as a combination of some different elements, and when we put that substance on a chemical reaction, we will get two different substances, two different elements from out of it, and those different elements have different properties different properties from the original compound, and those two substances which we got now from a compound can be used separately at different places. So that's what we are doing all the time, okay? We can use this plastic to form a pen, okay? Or who knows, we can use this as the same plastic but with different properties and with different shape and size and different use, clear? So, and these are the product of chemical reaction. So how we got these products? These products we got from some sort of chemical reactions, and both of them have different properties. Both of them are having different properties in it, clear? This is having different chemical and physical properties, this is having different physical and chemical properties, and thus different uses. So basically what is happening, either elements combines to form compounds, or compounds divided into elements, and according to their properties, either it is a compound or an element, according to their properties, scientists used to study the properties when they combine two elements and form a compound, or they divide a compound into two different elements. The scientists used to study their properties, and on the basis of their studies, and their properties, they uses all these things all around us. Okay, so basically that, and thus we got, there are so many things around us, okay, which are working together and makes our life very easy. Okay, so this is what happening all around us. So we are clear with the definition of element. Element is a substance which is having only one kind of atom, whereas compound is a substance which is obtained by the addition of, which is a pure substance which is chemically combined, which is obtained by the chemical combination of two or more elements. Clear? And have in a definite proportion of mass, when two or more elements combines to form combined in a definite proportion by mass, chemically they form a compound. Clear? And again, if you want to break it down, you can break that compound down in back into the basic constituent elements through chemical processes. You cannot do it physically. You cannot just like separate it like this, okay? Or you cannot just filter it with a filter paper or something. Clear? You have to apply some chemical methods, chemical processes to break it down, that we will learn later. Like for example, how hydrogen, when you pass electricity through water, water is a compound because it is not having only one kind of atom. It is a combination of two different kind of atoms. Clear? That's why it is a compound. And when you pass electricity through water, what will happen? Hydrogen and oxygen get separated from each other, and thus we got two different elements or constituent elements. So basically we can break down the compounds into constituent elements chemically. Clear? And as we have discussed, the properties of hydrogen and chlorine were different when they are elements, when they are separated from each other, when they are two different entities. But when they combined chemically and they form a chemical substance, that is HCl, its property is entirely different from its constituent substances. Clear? So this is what an element is. So this is what we have discussed already. So hydrogen, like carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen, okay, O2. When carbon, two molecules of carbon, when they combine together, it forms carbon dioxide, CO2. When carbon and oxygen used to combine, it forms CO2. Clear? So here again, two elements are combined together and form a compound. When hydrogen plus chlorine is added, that we have already discussed, when hydrogen and oxygen combines together, they form water. So these are few examples which represents compounds. Okay, so tomorrow we will be discussing mixtures, and then we will see what is the difference between, then we will be able to understand what is the difference between three bifurcations into which a matter can be bifurcated, that is elements, compounds and mixtures. So today we are clear till here, till this part, that is what is element, what are elements, what are compounds. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss mixtures. Thank you.